time to read this letter.
Jesse, give me a break.
You give me a break.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to call the order of the regular meeting of the Board of Public Works for July 24th, 2013. Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Present.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Present.
Carla Morgan.
Carla's absent. She's at a seminar in Chicago with the EPA today. Next, we have our minutes from the special meeting of July 3rd, 2013 and July 18th, 2013. I'd like to make a motion we accept these minutes as written.
So move.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Yes.
Okay, do we have any correspondence?
We do not.
Okay. We're going to move on to new business. For everybody who has agenda, we're going to move up three things that are further along down the agenda just because we have people here that are going to respond to these three items. So we'll just move them up, and then we'll do all the engineering things towards the end. First thing on agenda, we have 4933 Alexander. We have the opening of demolition proposals. Hey.
Good afternoon, Wina Guzman, Building Commissioner. Mm-hmm. 4933 Alexander, this property has been deemed unsafe under the unsafe building law, IC 3679, and as such have issued an emergency order to demolish due to the unsafe conditions it poses. As of today's date, we've been trying to attempt to get the owner to comply. However, he has failed and refused to comply in abating the unsafe conditions. And as such, I have requested demolition proposals to be submitted. There were two proposals submitted today, and I have turned them over to the clerk's office, to the clerk, Ms. Cosme. And I ask that the board open the sealed proposals before this public forum.
Okay, and in reference to this, you also have a letter here from Harbor Group.
Yes. In addition to that, this demolition is going to be a little complicated. Where this property is located within the Superfund zone, and we have EPA involved. We're attempting to remove any and all substructures. There are restrictions, and EPA will be working along EPA to attempt to remove the entire structure safely.
Okay. Now, once we open the bids, we'll read out the amounts, and then you're going to take these and review them to make sure everything's proper?
That's correct. Once I receive them, I will review them along with EPA, and we may have to hire a special inspector to be on site as well. So we'll be reviewing them along with EPA. I'll be faxing them over to them for their review, and I will make my recommendations at the next Board of Public Works meeting.
Okay. And we'll proceed with opening the bids. The demolition proposals, we have two. The first one's from JM Industrial Services of 201 Marble Street, Hammond. And let's see, total amount for $80,800. Second one is from Acton Incorporated, 1102 East Columbus Drive, Chicago, Indiana. $28,750. Okay, so we have the two. Except for J&M Industrial Services, $80,800. Acton Incorporated, $28,750. And I'll give you these two, and you could check to make sure everything's
I think if you give them to Olga, she'll make copies for her records, and then she will provide those to me, or I'll pick them up tomorrow.
Nope.
And I just want to note, we sent a request for proposals to 6 demolition contractors that are licensed with the city, so I just, and I just received 2. Thank you.
Thank you.
Quite a difference, isn't it?
No.
Okay, as I said before, we're going to move up some items. Next, we're going to take under consideration permission to advertise for fiber installation and termination RFP. Kevin?
Good afternoon. Kevin Klosek, System Administrator, City of East Chicago. I'm asking the board to consider permission to advertise for an RFP to install and terminate fiber optic cable that we have on hand with the city. This fiber optic would expand what we currently have available along the corridors of basically along the corridors of Indianapolis Boulevard from Roxana Drive through Columbus Drive and then east on Columbus Drive to the public safety facility. This would allow for expansion of single mode fiber, as I mentioned, which the city already has purchased and we've had on hand for some time now.
Okay, I know we've talked on this subject for a while before and there's a slight delay because I think we're waiting for there's an additional proposal from another entity, but we never received anything.
Okay.
So, are there any questions on?
No.
No? Okay, there being no other questions, I entertain a motion for permission to advertise for the fiber installation and termination RFP.
So move.
I'll second it. Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Kevin. Okay, next we're going to move up the police department, and I think they have 2 items here. First one will be the trailer move satellite with satellite company.
Hello, Sergeant Giorgio Medina, Police Department.
Okay, I know we had discussed this before, and I think this is the latest proposal.
Yes, sir.
And looking at this, this one is for a price of $3,565.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, through a curve in there was the demolished building and the big crater left.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know you've done a lot of work on this one, and I know it's been driving you a little crazy, but so I'm glad
they've been out there. They've had our crew actually go on site, so they're confident they can do it. I know they've spoken with the building department to take care of those issues. So,
and they check both sides. I mean, they check the new side where we're in.
Yes,
so they're aware of everything now.
Yes.
Okay. Any questions from the commission on this?
When do you plan to do this work? Finally, if this is approved tonight.
My hope would be to do this with next week or the week after that at the very latest. And it's only because I still have to coordinate with Comcast and Interpacific for the cameras. Don't want to, you know, to ensure it's all there and well lit and cameras are up and running. So it's a little tricky, but my goal is two weeks at the very latest, or week after next at the very latest.
Okay.
Okay. And as you said, building department checked everything out. There's no issues on this now, right?
They've spoken with the building department, yes.
Just want to make sure for the record.
Yes.
Nina Guzman, building commissioner. We are working with the contractor, the proposed contractor, to assist with expediting the licensing process, and we'll be working closely with them so we can get them rolling and get this trailer moved, because I know we're way behind on it. So we're trying to assist the police department in that effort.
Okay, thank you again, Weena. No other questions? Okay, then I'd like to make a motion that we accept the trailer move proposal from Satellite for the amount of $3,565.
So move.
Okay, roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Next, also from the Police Department, spot shotter proposal and service agreement.
John Verbich, Deputy Chief, East Chicago Police Department.
Now, I know last, was it a couple meetings ago, we approved...
Previous meeting, I believe.
Previous?
2 weeks ago.
Yeah, we've had those special meetings and it kind of kind of threw me off. So at that time, we approved the 1 year.
Right, and I think what we were trying to do is to not get in the way of the grant that the housing is has applied for, and we should have notification, I think, by the beginning of September or the end of September.
Right.
On the grant. And what we don't want to do is hold them back from going ahead. So if we don't get the grant, we'll get the 1 year one that the city will pay for, and if we get the grant, that we'll pick up the 3 year one with a substantial savings to the city. And
and just for the record, I know people watch our meetings on TV sometimes, so just explain it. We did approve it last time, but then we knew we submitted for a grant, and if we're awarded a grant and we enter into the contract before the grant, we can't use, you know,
correct,
the grant.
It would void the grant.
Right, so that's why we're doing this here.
So are we going to approve the 3 year subscription contingent to the grant approval tonight?
I think that was the idea.
Okay.
If we receive the grant, then the 3 year will go into effect.
Okay.
Correct.
So. Do we have a sign, Olga? Do we have a one we're supposed to sign on this one?
Yes. Yeah, it's page number 9. Page 9, it's...
It's on page 9?
Signature page. There are two different. There was one with standard terms. There is another one with agreement with the proposal.
Okay. Okay, so we're going to approve this one on condition that we win the grant, right? Okay. And in case we do not get the grant, we go back to the original one.
That's correct.
Okay. Any other questions, Jeff?
No.
Okay, then I'm going to make a motion that we accept the spot shooter proposal and service agreement on condition that if we are awarded the grant, this one will take precedence, and this one would be with the, if we do get the grant, this would be the 3 year one, and the 3 year one will be for the amount of $434,000. Like I said, this is on condition that we do get the grant, and if we do not win the grant, we will go back to the one for the 1 year for $194,000.
That's correct.
Okay, so that's my motion. Can I have a second?
I move that we approve this agreement with ShotSpotter agreement.
Okay, roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Okay, now we're going to go back to our regular... Now, I think our first one on here will be NIS Engineering, Todd Avenue, additional scope.
Yeah, this is a change order or additional scope of work for Todd Avenue project. There is a representative of NIS Engineering here, but I can explain this. Basically, we had to, there was another section of sewer that couldn't be relined as part of the Army Corps project, and now that we're gonna do this project on Todd, the water main and Milvenpay, we decide to add that scope to this project, so the designer had to amend the plans, basically. Let me see. Yeah, I have a copy of that. So, you have a copy with you? So the amended contract price for this project was the amount of we previously amended this project, this contract. So the previous amount was $26,305.80, and this will increase the contract amount for another for $1,520, with a total of $27,825.80 to cover the that additional work of top project. I didn't have it either. That's amazing. Should be there. Yeah, probably it probably is missing.
I didn't get a copy of it.
But you can read it's a letter.
Mm-hmm.
basically explain, you know, the additional scope of work that they already did. We had no option. We want to award these projects. We're going to award this project this afternoon. And at that time, we didn't want to delay the project for that. So
the amount is $1,520?
Yeah, that will be the extra amount for the contract.
Okay. I have no other questions. Okay, then I'd like to make a motion that for Talent Avenue, additional scope of work for the added amount, amended contract price at amount of $1,520.
I move that we accept this total Todd Avenue additional scope of work from Nice Engineering.
Okay, roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Yes.
Okay, next we have Private Street Bid Recommendation Award.
Yeah, this is a notice to award for the Private Street Reconstruction and Parking Lot Meal Pay Project for the amount of $124,716.92. The written value was the lowest bidder for this project. Nice Engineering reviewed the bid. They comply with everything except the ordinance. They didn't include the minimum requirements. So other than that, they comply with all the documentation. So I would like to make a motion to accept this bid contingent to a letter or something, any kind of commitment from Reed and Riley, saying that they're going to meet the minimum requirement for ordinance 05-0020 and 05-0019.
Okay.
I already contact Reed and Riley, and they are taking a look to all this. So they're aware of this. They want to do the work. They're supposed to get back to me pretty soon with an answer. If maybe we can give them like maybe a week. If they don't, they're not willing to comply with the ordinance, I guess we'll have to go with the second lowest bidder or rebid the project. So, but today I would like to make a recommendation contingent to receive something from Brittany Riley to comply with the ordinances.
Okay, so your motion is approving them on condition of that we get the reply.
And give them a specific time to submit the documentation.
So in your motion, we're going to add 1 week?
I would say 1 week.
Okay, they have 1 week from today then?
From today.
Okay, that's your motion?
Yes.
Okay, I'll second it. Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Okay. Next we have construction inspection for private street.
I can explain that as well. This is for the same project, private street. I requested a proposal for inspection services to different companies, and Northwest Engineer. The proposal, it was I would say the lowest, not only because it was the lowest, but I contact them and make sure they're gonna provide good service for inspection services for this project, and they feel comfortable with the grand total that they are proposing on this proposal. So if you can see there, you can see the services, they itemize the services. If you have any question, I'll be more happy to answer those. This is to oversee the construction. You want to read it, that's fine.
Okay. Yeah, I just had my papers mixed up. Okay.
I can read the item. Basically, they're going to attend the pre-construction meeting, provide construction inspection services as required. Attend progress meeting between the contractor and the city of Chicago as required. Review contractor, develop progress schedule, and provide city of Chicago with comments. Review and approve contractor pay estimate in accordance with the contract document. Send comments when necessary to the city of Chicago. Prepare and submit progress report, project schedule, and progress payment and monthly basic. Review job drawings, submit all technical conformance to the requirement of the plans and the specification. Answer queries from the contractor. And review and recommend approval, substantial completion, and final project completion certificates. The total amount of this proposal is $7,000, $440.
Okay. Well, based on your recommendation, then, I'd like to make a motion that we accept the construction inspection services with Northwest Engineering Company, Incorporated, for an amount of $7,440.
So move.
Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Okay, next we come to the Todd Avenue Northcott bid recommendation.
Okay, this bid was a bid that we opened in our special meeting last week. this is a notice to award that Nice Engineering Designer review all the bids, and they're recommending HASI Construction as the lowest and most responsive bidder. The total amount of the bid was $1,793,922. Also, I received an email from Human Rights Director Consuelo Magana, saying that they comply with the ordinance. They comply with the minimum requirements. So, basically, I would like to make a recommendation toward this project, unless you have any questions.
No, I don't have any questions. So, based on your recommendation, I'll make a motion that we accept the Todd Avenue Northcott bid recommendation for HASI for the amount of $1,793,922.
I move that we accept this award for Todd Avenue project.
Yeah, roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jethro Rodriguez?
Yes.
Okay. Next, we have professional service agreement with Primera. Primera.
This is basically, there was the agreement that we approved. We approved a proposal 2 weeks ago, and this is a contractual agreement that includes more information about, it's more formal agreement other than a proposal. So you can see they have from Article 1 to Article 13, I believe. So, and they attach the proposal previously signed by these four as an exhibit. They're asking for a signature. I don't see any problem with this, especially something that we already approved.
Mm-hmm. So basically, we approved it, it just goes into more detail, or?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, I don't have any issue with it. I'd like to make a motion that we approve the professional service agreement with Primera as had previously approved by this board.
Okay, I move that we, I second the motion.
Okay, roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jethro Rodriguez?
Yes.
Okay, next we have revised change order number 11, Todd Avenue Reconstruction Project.
Yes, this is a revised change order. We already approved change order number 11 for Todd Avenue. Probably 3 meetings ago. The difference with the change order was approved. It is, when we approve that change order, we approve option one. Option one contingent to have a housing authority to collaborate with or help with the cost of this work. However, they can. They have some regulation and rule that they just can't help the city. They will have to go through the bid process, you know, get quotes, bylaw. So what this revised change order entail is option two that was approved before. We add more work, basically fix and at the alley on Todd that lead to the senior citizen building. So previously we approved a change order, I believe, for an amount of around $50,000. So the revised amount now is $22,265. And the reason that it's more because we add more work. That alley is in bad shape, and if we don't do it now, we'll have to do it later. So now that I would say the contractor is going to be doing some work in the area, it's a good time to do it now.
Okay. So, okay, based on your recommendation then, I'll make a motion that we approve revised change order number 11. For the Todd Avenue Reconstruction Project for the amount of $22,265.
So move.
Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jethro Rodriguez?
Yes.
Okay, now comes a change order number 12 for Todd Avenue Reconstruction.
change order number 12 was necessary. There's a sewer on the 149th Street between Alcott and Todd that need to be repaired, need to be replaced. We asked Hasse Construction that to submit a proposal. This proposal was reviewed by First Group Engineering, the consultant doing inspection. They recommend the work. The price is reasonable. Even the total amount is $96,350, but based on the is a deep sewer that need to be replaced. Also, two manholes need to be replaced. It's a brick, 24 inches brick sewer, a 200 linear feet of sewer. It's a 24 PVC SDR 26 pipe. So mm-hmm. There's a scope of work include 310 square yard of asphalt removal and disposal, replacement of 200 linear feet of 24 inches brick sewer, removal of two brick manholes with 2 5-foot diameter concrete manholes, include reconnection of two inlet sewer, abandon the 60 manhole by meaning the filling with flowable fill, installation of two concrete columns and to tie the new pipe into a 60, installation 12 inch of stone 53 base aggregate up to the 16 top to the pavement, installation 14 feet of 10 inch PVC lateral sewer, installation of dewatering the City of Chicago residency ordinance required included. So okay. It was recommended by First Group, and this is something that if we don't do it now, we'll have to do it later, and it's better to do it now that mm-hmm. just finish Todd south of Chicago. We don't want to have future problems.
And this is a sewer that collapsed so much that we can't even get a camera line through there, right?
Yes, we tried to televise, and the sanitary district tried to televise, they couldn't. There's definitely some issues.
So we're almost at a total collapse on there.
Right now, apparently there's a collapse, but.
Okay. So, based on your recommendation then, I'd like to make a motion that we approve change order number 12 for Todd Avenue Reconstruction Project from 151st to Chicago Avenue.
So move.
Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jethro Rodriguez?
Yes.
Okay, next. We have R&D Construction Concrete Proposal.
Yeah, this is a proposal that I requested. It's just to try to open a PO and have it just in case something needs to be done immediately. We don't have to go through, you know, the process of get quotes and wait a couple weeks. So the price I would propose, it's a good price. also, the company has done work for us before. They really provide good service, a good quality of work. So it's a flat rate for removal, installation of concrete sidewalk for $5 a square feet, with a minimum of 250 square feet. And also concrete curb and gutter, $30 a linear feet, minimum 20 linear feet. And finally, if necessary, sometime, you know, we have to replace sod, it's a 150 square feet of for sod removal and replacement. So it's a flat rate. So I am satisfied with this company. They have done work for us, and I would like to make a motion and approve those rates. as needed.
Okay, so that's your motion?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll second it. Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Okay, that brings us to our June 2013 compliance report for Todd Reconstruction Project. This comes from our East Chicago Human Rights Commission. This is our monthly report from Consuelo Gonzalez Mangana, our executive director. I'd like to make a motion. We accept this as written.
So move.
Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Okay, that brings us to right-of-way applications from the engineering department.
Okay, the first application number 13-02083, it's a right-of-way permit. Location 4902 Magoon Avenue. Description, sandblast brick wall and tuck point. 13-02084, dumpster permit, 39817 Hemlock Street. It will be used during repairs to the roof of a single-story house. Next one, 13-02085, location 3411 Grand Boulevard. Description, replace drywall, tile vanity, remove paneling, and replace flooring. Next one, 13-02086, it's a dumpster. Location 3619 Grand Boulevard. Description, replacing roof. And the final one is 13-02087. It's a heavy load permit. Location, Dickey Road. Description, hauling and to Dickey Road and return.
Okay.
Is there any question?
I have no questions. There being no questions, I'd like to make a motion that we accept right-of-way applications from the engineering department, 13-02083 through 13-02087.
So move.
Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Okay, I think we addressed everything under new business.
Yeah, well, I have another item that was, it's not in the agenda, but I just want to include it now. We, through NDOT, we advertise construction engineering services for Bering Avenue. The deadline was today, and we receive, four proposals or I would say letter of intent, that's the right word, from four different companies to do this inspection. One from Lochner, other one from DLC, another one from Nice Engineering and American Structure Point. So I'm gonna review those. We don't have to make any decision. Today is just more like to inform this board that they're going to be reviewing those, and you know, a company will have to be selected to do the inspection services. That's something that we will have to discuss later.
Okay, so this is just for information?
Yes.
And this will be taken up at next?
I guess maybe next meeting we'll come in, we can make a recommendation. The first step will be, you know, analyze the proposal and go through a scoring process, send those to NDOT as well, and select one company to do the work. So take time, you know, and you have to select the company, then negotiate the price as well.
So NDOT has to give approval also?
Yes.
Okay.
So it's a process that we have to follow if we are using federal money. So hopefully by next meeting we'll have an agreement, or at least, you know, decide what company we're going to go with.
Mm-hmm. So we'll just take it to see when we get the information then. So
yes,
possibly, hopefully next meeting, but if not, it'll be the next meeting after that.
Mm-hmm. Yes, for sure.
Okay, so we don't have to take any action now?
No.
Okay, is there anything else?
No.
Okay, is there any old business?
No.
Any other business? No. That concludes our business, new, other, and old. Our next regular meeting will be Wednesday, August 14th, 2013 at 4:30 p.m. There being order business, I entertain a motion for adjournment.
So move.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Yes.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to welcome you to the Chicago Board of Public Safety. If we could begin with our Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic which stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
A roll call.
Richard Morrisrow.
Present.
Thomas Davis.
Present.
Richard Tremzinski.
Present.
We have before us our minutes from the June 26th meeting. Entertain a motion to accept.
Make a motion to accept.
Second.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisrow.
Accept.
Thomas Davis.
Accept.
Richard Tremzinski.
Accept.
Do we have any correspondence?
We do not.
New business, prompt ambulance, our public report on emergency medical services. We have an extensive list of calls, and we also have about 15 delayed response reports, which concern occurrences that took more than 6 minutes to arrive. We review those, and then we have a quarterly meeting convened by Mr. Herbie Cruz of our Homeland Security Department that looks into some of these. We usually don't review them at this meeting. Entertain a motion to accept these reports of Mr. Cruz and of Prompt Ambulance.
I so move.
I second the motion.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisrow.
Accept.
Thomas Davis.
Accept.
Richard Tremzinski.
Accept.
We now turn to our building department, Mr. David Matthews, electrical inspector and deputy of the building department, along with Chris Cantor, the special counsel for the building department. Attorney Chris Cantor.
Good afternoon, board.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
David. What is submitted is the status reports for the properties in East Chicago for your review.
Now, the status report is the later document you gave us today or the one we received in the mailing? The one, the mailing is dated July 23rd.
Well, the status report is from June to July.
Okay. Is that the one you handed us this afternoon?
The one I handed this afternoon is basically the same thing.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Is there anything you want to point out about the status report? Any of the buildings or items that...
On 4006 Alexander, there is progress being made. An order to demolish has never actually been entered on the property. We've been continuing it. And I would like maybe perhaps a...
This is the church with Reverend Chandler?
It's the church?
It's the garage at that location.
Okay.
I mean, the 4006 Alexander, that's a two-story, four-unit structure that is going to be remodeled.
and I was just looking for a status date, maybe either 2 or 3 months out, just to keep an eye on the progress.
Whichever you prefer.
3 months?
3 months.
How about 3 months?
That'd be fine.
Can I have the date 3 months when I was president?
Madam Secretary, do we have that date?
It'd be October 30th, perhaps?
No, it'd be the third, the fourth. So if it's the 30th, then we'd be talking about the 23rd. October 23rd.
Okay. What's going on with 49? The bids are being opened, right?
Or that's correct. The bids for 4933 Alexander is under review.
Okay. Mr. President, on 4933 Alexander, that's the only one I did not process. That was an emergency order to demolish, and right now they're reviewing the bids for the demolition of that structure.
I believe they came before the Board of Works this afternoon.
Correct. Now, 4021 Carey, that was previously ordered demolished. There has been no compliance, and that one is going to be put out to bid. Of course, title updates would have to be ordered because it's been a great length of time, and the property may have changed hands on tax sale, but that one will be proceeding to bid.
All right.
Now, on the success story column, on 3932 McCook, there is a garage. Significant progress has been made so that the board will now be presented with an order to rescind the previously issued demolition order.
It's so nice to have one of those occasionally.
It happens sometimes. If I may approach, Mr. President.
Certainly.
And that is when the board has time to consider it, to rescind the demolition order on that property.
Well, is there any reason why we should delay the consideration and not simply enter it?
No, but I never ask anybody just to trust things on blind faith. If you want to look at it, that's fine.
Well, our faith is not blind.
If you want to sign it, that would be fine too.
Okay. Consider?
Yes.
Great.
I was looking for some enlightening line of Paul for as to why our faith is not blind, but couldn't come up with one at the moment.
Because the garage is fixed, Mr. President.
Well, that's sufficient.
But the garage is down.
Well, okay, then it's down. There's nothing for it to
move. The slab, I assume, is still there.
Yes, sir.
And then lastly, Mr. President, I have 3938 Pulaski, which is also a property that has been making significant progress. Demolition order was not entered at any point in time, so there's nothing to rescind. I would just ask for perhaps maybe a status date of that October 23rd, if it's acceptable to the board.
This is one in which a neighbor kept coming and saying, please help my aunt, if I recall. And the neighbor eventually did do as she had promised.
I have Jessica Gonzalez and Marilyn Rodriguez as the owners, so I'm not sure if that was the neighbor or the aunt. That's all I have on the demolitions, Mr. President. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer.
Does Mr. Matthews have anything to add?
No, sir.
We'll simply entertain a motion to accept these reports and thank you for them.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Make a motion to accept these reports.
I'll second the motion.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisroll.
Accept.
Thomas Davis.
Accept.
Richard Chemzinski.
Accept.
Then the final item is the notice of emergency order to demolish. Is that something we need to address, or that's been already at 3802 Drummond and 3610 Kennedy? They're on here, or simply we're perhaps receiving notice that the order was entered.
That's correct, Mr. President. Mr. Matthews does have copies of those two documents.
I have one of them. I have. I have a notice of the emergency order to vacate to Mr. Magana for 4610 Kennedy. perhaps we received, or did we receive the others under separate cover?
Where it says other, notice the notice of emergency order to, it's not to demolish. It's a vacate order.
Okay.
Due to the fact that there was no water services at that location at 3802 Drummond. Now, 4610 Kennedy, the former Indiana Pellet Company, there was a notice, emergency order to vacate.
That's on our sheet, it says 3610 Kennedy.
4610 Kennedy.
Okay.
Well, there was a...
And we have that. That was given to us.
Yes.
I think it's a typo that blew my mind. But we have that dated July 17th, 2013. The notice of emergency order to vacate an unsafe premise, and I believe that was a major building on the former U.S.
Indiana Pellet.
Indiana Pellet, but before that it was U.S. Reduction. Yes.
Yes, sir.
At the corner, catty corner from the post office at on Chicago Avenue at Kennedy. Okay, so we'll entertain both of those and simply accept those.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Is there any other question or comment?
No, sir.
Do we have any old business?
We do not.
Any other business? If I may announce, we'd like to reconvene for our next regular meeting, August 14th, 5:30, here in these same august chambers. Any other comments before we entertain a motion to adjourn?
I have none.
I have none.
Entertain the motion.
I so move.
I second the motion.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisrow.
Adjourn.
Thomas Davis.
Adjourn.
Richard Tremzinski.
Adjourn.